Labels offer instructors the ability to be creative with the presentation of their course page. Labels can display as text, images, or any multimedia items. On this page, the instructor has put three labels. These three are all image labels. This first one is a general image showing banking, customer service, and telephones. This one makes it clearer that this is a reading section, and this final one is for listening. Adding a label to your course. Let's now look at adding different kinds of labels to your course. First, I'll turn editing on. Then I'll scroll down and click the Add an Activity or Resource link in the appropriate topic. Next, I'll click on Label in the Activities tab. The Label Editing screen appears with one row of editing tools. I'll click on this Show More Buttons button to see more options. This expanded editing toolbar has everything we need to create a more functional and interesting experience for our learners. The first thing we're going to do is create a heading. We already have a reading section in the course, but I'll create another one for demonstration purposes and call it reading number 2. I'll highlight the text and then click on this font icon and format it as medium. Then I'll scroll down and click Save and return to course. We now have a new section called Reading Number 2, but it's at the bottom of the course. I can move it up either by dragging it or clicking on this icon. I'll find the reading section that we already have and place this Reading 2 section that we're using for demonstration purposes underneath it. Here is the new section called Reading Number 2. I'd like to make some more changes to it, so I'll click on this Edit button. Beside the heading here, I want to put in a reading image, so I'll click on this Insert Image icon. Just a small note here. The icon beside the Insert an Image is to insert multimedia, like an audio file or a video file. And it will be the same process as we're going to learn here to insert or upload an image. I'll click on Browse Repositories. The file picker appears. I'll locate Upload a File in the left column, and then I'll click on Choose a File. I'll navigate and find a reading image that I found on the internet that was copyright free, and I'll click on it. I'll click Upload this file. I see a message telling me to type a description for people who may have a disability and cannot see it. I'll type reading image in the description area and click on Save Image. I'm going to do one more thing before we leave here. I'm going to go to a new line and then put in a horizontal line to delineate or separate this section from the next section, the listening section. First, I'll click on the Show More Buttons button. Then I'll find the HTML Source Editor icon and click on it. The editor becomes an HTML Source Editor, and HTML code can be input to make customizations to your course appearance. I'll type the letters HR and put them between these brackets. Then I'll scroll down and click on Save and return to course. That's the end of this tutorial. We've created three labels: text, an image, and a horizontal line to separate it from the next section or topic. This may seem complicated at first, but after you do a few of these, I think you will find that adding labels won't be so difficult and will enhance learners' experience with your course content.